In this lesson, we're going to work on using a template from Word. One of the most common templates that you might use would be a resume. They have many different choices in resume, and you can pick any one that you like. I'm just going to select the basic resume and the timeless design. I'm going to hit Create. And then we're going to start making some basic modifications and seeing how it's set up. Notice that when I select a specific area, like experience, I can hit plus to add more. So for example, if I'm doing it for my education, you would usually include your college, possibly your high school. For me, I would include 3 degrees because I'm currently in progress on a master's, which is similar to what many of you are doing at MCC. So the school would be Capella, and that's in, it's Capella University in Minnesota. And I'm working on a master's in instructional design for online learning. And you usually want to put in your graduation date. And then you'd want to put in a summary. And you would go on to include your GPA if it's higher than 3. If it's below 3.0, don't include it. So that's the basics for getting started. Generally, you don't want to have more than 1 to 2 pages. In a professional arena, you might get further than that, but typically you won't. And so undo is a wonderful thing. You can eliminate any sections that you don't intend to use by deleting them. And you'll notice that it's actually done in a table. So it can be helpful to view the grid lines. That'll show you how your layout really is working, and it makes it much easier to work with. So I don't expect you to have leadership or communication in here. So you can just cut those out or delete them. Skills can be at the bottom or at the top, and you're going to replace all the text in here. So you're going to have an objective section, a skills section, an experience, and an education section. And it should be 1 to 2 pages long when you're done. When you're writing it, you'll include your real name, but everything else on here could be fictional. I don't care if you make it up. Keep it clean, so that don't use your real address, don't use your real phone or email. And it's okay to make up the content here. I'm really worried about you working with the format, not the content of your resume. You may choose to use different colors in here. If you'd like, feel free to play with those. Try and keep it professional and clean looking. And you would choose differently depending on if you're going to be using a color or black and white printer, as well as what your profession is. You'd probably be a little bit more bold if you're going into graphic arts than if you're going into programming or something like that. But please go ahead and play with the themes and the colors. Find one that you like and move forward with it. So that's what you have to do to use a template for a resume in Word.